Hello and welcome back, my beautiful people. Last time we implemented a collision, so our bullet could hit our enemy and implemented some hitboxes so we can see where the collision should be. This time we'll implement a score, so every time we hit our enemy we get points, and we will make a life bar, which will be, with each hit, the health of the enemy will be decreasing. And if the health bar is empty, like it's totally red, because normally a health bar is green, then it's decreasing to red. And if he has no health anymore, then he will disappear. So, as exciting as that, let's get right into it. And now, if we want to have a score, therefore we need firstly to implement a score variable. So you go to our window settings and put in a score is equal to 0 over there, because in the beginning you will have 0 points. Yeah, you need to earn your point. Like this. Then we go to our main loop. And here, before our main loop, there is our draw window function, and before this, we will implement a font. To display a score, we need to make a font, which will be then rendered like an image, and then we can plit this font into our game. So let's have a look. We can make font is equal to pygame.font.sysfont, and here you put in the name of the font you want to have. I make Comic Sans. Yeah. Then the next one is the size of the font. I've tested with 30 because 30 is pretty good. And then the question, you want to have it in bold or italic? Let's take bold, but I don't like italic that much. So if you want to set it to italic as well, just implement a true after that as well. And now in the draw window function, we can implement our score. Therefore, we make a variable called text, which will render our font. So we make font.render, and in here we can put a string, then this alias, there you can put simply one and then the color of your text. Therefore we make a f string, which is called score colon, and here we can put in our score variable. Oh, not an hashtag, but score variable as this. Then you put in the one, easy as that, and then a tuple with your color, RGB. I wanted a dark gray, so I take 40, 40, 40. And now we can go with like the images, where we plit everything on our screen. There we can simply make win.plit, and here you put in your text and a tuple where it should be located. Now we check the height and the width of our window, and we can adjust it. Yeah, like this. The height is 480 and the width is 850. So we need to check the height. We want to get it in the upper right corner. So we need from the height starting from 0 to higher ones at the bottom. So we can simply check if we go from like 20 or something like this here. And the width was 850, so this will be a long string. Let's check 800. What is it saying? 820. And simply check what's happening. Let's run the pygame 09. And yeah, that's a bit. I think the height is good, but we need to adjust it more to the left. Let's take 700 this time, because this is a long string. Yeah, I like it, I like it. Not gonna lie. But we don't get points yet. And that is pretty simple. We had over here, if the bullets hit our enemy, like in the main loop, then we hit the enemy. And there we can simply increase our score. And I like it. Well, let's do it by 10. More points, make more fun, and that's cool. And now, yeah, we get some points in here. Pretty cool. And now we come to the second part of this video. We want to get a health bar to our enemy. Therefore, we need two new properties for our enemy. Go to the enemy. We go to the enemy. And the first one is self.health. How much health it should be. Like how often he should get hit until he dies. And let's set this to 10. 10 is a cool number. And the next one is, should he, if he is dead, then he should disappear. So we make self.visible. By now we will simply make him invisible if he is away. But later on we can delete him and create a new instance. So we set self.visible is equal to true. Because as long he has health, he should be visible. Then we go to the drawing function. And this one's pretty simple. We check. We had the hitbox in here. The hitbox is self.x plus 22, self.y, 28 and 55. So now we want to get a new rectangle, a red rectangle, above the hitbox, which goes like 5 or 6 pixel left-hand side, right-hand side, above the hitbox. And the second thing is we make a green rectangle, which has the exact same position. So we have, see the green rectangle like the health bar. And later on, we can make the size of this green rectangle smaller. And then the red rectangle will stay there. And it looks like the health of the enemy is decreasing if you hit him. So first we pygame.draw.rect. Of course, we need our window. And the first one should be red. 255, 0, 0, and where it should be positioned. So let's check. We get the hitbox in here. The hitbox. Let's check the x value of the hitbox and the y value of the hitbox. And then we take like 10 more than this. So this will have 6 pixels on the left hand side and 6 to the right hand side. And then we make a height of 10. Yeah, like this. Put in a tuple self.hitbox at position 0. We will later be able to adjust this, so we simply test it how this is looking. Then we want 40 and the height was 10. So let's check the rectangle. And yeah, let's set this a bit higher and a bit more to the left hand side. So to the left hand side. We have 40 and there we had the width of 28. So we have 12 pixels more. So we can set it like 6 pixels more to the left to be in the middle. There we simply subtract 6. And if we want to get it higher, we need to subtract something as well. Let's do like 20 pixels. Check this. How this is looking. Wow. This is beautiful. And now simply copy this because the green rectangle over there should have the same values. Only change the color RGB, so green is the second value. And if you see it now, there should be a green rectangle. Yeah! Now we have a health bar, but the health bar doesn't change if we attack the enemy. Therefore, we have the health variable. Like the enemy has here the health of 10. This will be a bit like here. We have 40. And if he has a health of 10, so if his health is increasing each time, it should go 4 times lower. Therefore, we can subtract like the maximum of the health is 10 minus self.health and 4 times of this. This is a bit hard to understand, but the maximum of the health is 10. So if we have full health, then this will be 10 minus 10. So this is 0. So we subtract 0 from there. And the green health bar has the full size. If we lose one point of health, then this will be 10 minus 9. We have a 1 in here and we will subtract 4. So the width of the green health bar will decrease and we see a little bit of a red health bar. And now we need to decrease the health every time the enemy gets hit. So we check self.health 11 minus equals 1. Check this. If the health bar is decreasing now. And yeah. Ooh, I'm good in this game. And yeah, nothing's happening if the enemy is dead because we didn't implement this yet. And there we can check if our health is greater than 1. If the enemy's health is greater than 1, then he should be alive. And if he is alive, he can lose health. If he's not alive, then we can set the visibility of the enemy simply to false. So it should disappear if he has no health. And how we can check now if he's disappearing? We can simply take everything in the enemy draw function, tap it in, and make a condition if self.visible. Because if this is true, then the enemy has life and can still play. Yeah, let's make here a line break. Yeah. Let's have a look what's happening. Now. Get him. And yeah, he's away. But we can simply score on and on because he's still there, but he isn't visible anymore. We don't see him, but he is still there. Now you can hit your enemy and even deny his health so he will disappear. In the upcoming videos, we will make some sound for the shooting, for the enemies or something like this to get more like a feeling of this game. And then we can even get rid of this hitboxes because they look ugly, but we now know how these hitboxes of the single characters are working. And yeah, then we can check that we delete the instance of this object after we killed him and maybe make some more hard levels, like we will have multiple enemies. And yeah, we can go on with this. Hope you enjoyed the video, subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for more of game development. Thank you.